Hi, I'm Robert Riggs with the Clarity Blog, and that's my partner Brad Besakin throwing sticks in the creek here today. Brad, you going to join us and tell me why we're out here where it's really silent and with nature?
Yeah, I was just out here enjoying the quiet, which is where we find a lot of our clients and customers out in the middle of nowhere when it comes to their social media.
They're not listening, and no one's talking.
Not listening, not understanding. And they tend to just put themselves out there on an island or out in the middle of the woods like we are, and never really understanding who their client is, where their client is, who their customer is, and what they're doing.
So we have our process called Listen, Think, Speak, and we're going to talk about our approach to listen today. And you brought my camera out here and all of this.
It's a great place though, isn't
it? Oh yeah, it's great.
It's very quiet. So hopefully you guys are hearing the quiet, because again, that's where a lot of folks are in social media. No written strategy, no understanding of who their client is, where they are, what they're doing. And the critical piece that we teach our clients is, who are their customers inside of each one of the social medias like Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, for example? Customers tend to be different in each one of those particular medias.
And we like to talk to about them as an audience, much like coming out of broadcast television. We talk about the audience. What kind of responsive chord do you want to strike with them? You're going to call them markets, customers, but again, there's segments, there's different members of that audience, and we do something called audience speak.
Absolutely, and that's really going out there, helping our clients understand their customers, where they are, who they are, and then creating that language that speaks inside of those social media pieces that their customers are enjoying, and how to inject their brands into that in the right language.
So what I've seen many, many companies doing is just throwing stuff out there, and I really compare it to graffiti on that New York subway car, which is a long ways from here, from when I live there. But talk about that, about what you're doing to your brand, that you might even end up as an accidental brand.
Well, absolutely. And the challenge with that is the only people that understand the graffiti on the subway are the people that put it up on the subway. And that's the piece that we teach and listen phase is all about, which is writing the right graffiti so that everyone in your social realm understands that.
So as an example of how we've used listen for our clients, we've got a client that has a very high-end exotic car collection. We reached out with a photograph of one of the cars in his collection to the CEO of Mercedes, and we did it at the right time. We did it real time. Talk about how we used audience speak there and how it worked.
Right. So the CEO of Mercedes-Benz USA a few weeks ago tweeted that it was their best quarter ever. I simply, understanding their language and understanding the passion of that brand, just sent a congratulations tweet with a picture of our client's 60s model 190 SL, which is a very popular car in the Mercedes-Benz world. Tweeted it to him, copied in or tweeted to Mercedes-Benz USA. They actually used it the next day as their Throwback Thursday tweet, word for word, and we're still getting amplification off of that and retweets off of it, and now it's been 4 to 5 weeks later. It's been in Venezuela, Europe, it's been all over the place.
The lesson here of Listen, Think, Speak is don't end up in the middle of nowhere.
Don't end up in the middle of nowhere.
Media.